Hello, everybody. I'm coming from my private cottage. You want to see it, Lucas?
Sure.
Come here.
All right.
Okay. It's a little messy, but it's what it is. Oops.
Let's see Maria's crib.
Oh, my God. My clothes is on the floor. I forgot how embarrassing is that. Okay, it's a reason, guys. A reason my clothes in the floor. Because what happened, I take all my winter clothes home in the car yesterday. I pull everything out. It's hot. It's hot in here, humid. So now it's not summer anymore here in Florida. It's not winter anymore, excuse me. So I gotta bring all my winter clothes here, my summer clothes. I gotta take all my winter clothes. So I put it here, and then I'm gonna hang it when I have time. That you know I'm gonna hang it, I promise. Anyway, this is the area where I come over here. I put a desk in here, and this is where I sit down, and Diane sits here. I sit here, and we play. Think about what to do. And this, I have ties to tie the desert rosas, that way their stems don't break. I have my hats here. I have some of my shoes here. More hats over here. I have some of my, when I had to build my face, is here. I'm so silly. Anyway, I have a little bit of everything and I have the moisture testers. So I have stuff that I need, I buy some books that I need. I have a lot of cinnamon, as you see that, a lot of stuff. Anyway, so this is where I work a little bit. I have papers that I send with the boxes for instructions over here. I'm a little organized, I have everything. I have a box in here where I put the names for the color of the desert roses. And everything. So anyway, this is it. Diane and I, this is her desk. No, this is her dresser. Let's see what she has. She has oil spray.
Where's my desk?
Oh, she has gloves. Your desk? Not belong here, Lucas. Belong the other side.
That's right.
She has some clothes in here. I give her this dresser because I say, you can put your stuff here and I put my stuff there. And she has a box full of shoes there. So we share this cottage here, and I, my friend Diane, my best friend. Anyway, she's a lot like me. So this is it. Let's close it because we want to keep it cool. Okay, remember a week ago, oh, by the way, you see I hang all my watering cans, tea pads. I like them. So hanging here, it's in a garden idea you can do. The only thing is you're going to hang them outside, totally outside, okay? Totally outside. What I did, I put fish line over here, and I make a good knot that way doesn't break. If you're gonna put this outside, I will recommend you think about how it's gonna be hang, so I will drill a hole here. Why? That way, if you're gonna use it for decoration outside, you need definitely to drill a hole around whatever you're gonna hang it over here. That way, the water, running water, doesn't hold in there, and it's gonna be a little bit uncomfortable smell. So you're gonna keep in here. You don't need to drill a hole, because I gotta get in here. Because they are just hanging there because they look cute. I had this mirror over here that was very rusted, so I take the mirror out. And I paint the frame, and I put the mirror back, and it's a nice piece, it's metal. So, many ideas come to my head. Oh my God. I guess, I don't know, it's crazy. Anyway, today we're gonna talk about how to re-roof your either ceilings, your root plants, your plants that have root damage. Not necessarily has to be root rot. Or your plants, they have too much roots and you just don't like them anymore, and it's looking ugly. So this over here, remember I showed it to you a couple days ago? The ones that Diane and I find across the field, the old planting. Each little baby deserves a chance. Either this one that looks like this, okay? Each one, this very dry and dehydrated, but it's hard like a rock. So each one that says that deserves a chance. So they have to be here for 6 weeks with a little tiny big water. Every 3-4 days I come and I just wet the top like this much. No more than that, and that's it. So, I don't know if you notice, but I notice little nuts in here and there. Those things, if you put your desert rose, you cut your desert rose and put cinnamon and put it in the shade, like I suggested, I don't know, 6-7 months ago, you have very high chance that those tiny little nuts are gonna get the plant root right. How do I know? My goodness, I do this all day. So this plant over here, I just put it here today so we can take it out. So remember in the last video, I showed you this plant that was belong to the guy that belongs to the other 1, 2, 3, 4. Everything was hard except here, remember? So what I did, I didn't want to cut it anymore. I'm done cutting it. I don't want to cut it. So I just want to work with it. So I clean it up very good with a paper towel and apply cinnamon. And then after I apply cinnamon, I put the glue in here. And it's all nice and dry now. So now I can plant it. So how do I plant it? Just like this. This is how we're going to plant it. Come on, baby. So this is how you're going to plant it. That's all the plant needs. Also, the plant needs moisture. When dries, every time it dries, every state, every country is different because according to humidity, according to your weather, all depends. So all these over here are in the 6 weeks recovery. That's what I call it, 6 weeks recovery. 6 weeks is gonna take for them to get roots again. So like I said, this one is very, very dehydrated. I'm gonna have to cut it here and here. Also, this one over here looks hard and like a rock. But over here, you see this, how wrinkled is this stem? It's not good at all. Means all the cells inside are too dry, and I don't know if it's gonna be possible for this plant to take water again here. This plant might die, I don't know. But every plant that says a chance. So this happened to me like a year ago. I dried this plant too long. And what happened, by the time I tried to restart it and recover it, the main mistake I make was getting stems. The stems, like this stem is so dry. It's not root rot. It's so dry that all the cells inside are dead. And it's not gonna suck water anymore. It's not gonna take water. So I'm gonna have to cut it here. And this is one of the ones that I found across the lot, across the street in the lot. But you never know, the old plantain, I have old plantain in here. These two are gonna make it. These two are the ones the lady brought to me. They were like 24 years old and they were full of moss and all kind of stuff in here. So I have a very, very hard time getting them back to in shape. Why? Because they were neglected for this one, maybe 25 years, maybe 15, 16 years. So by the time I got it, was a mess. So I was trying my best. Thanks God that I, the time I know about the glue. So they're hard like a rock and they're in recovery for 6 weeks. In 6-7 weeks, I'm gonna give them 8 weeks. In 8 weeks, I'm gonna pull them out and I'm gonna show you they're gonna have roots. They are gonna have roots, these two. They're gonna make it. This belongs to the other guy, it's three in here. This this one over here, this and this belongs to my friend, Evie. Hi, Evie. Evie drive 3-4 hours to come see me one day and I was not here. My heart was broke. I feel terrible. Yeah, that Evie. So this one's Evie. This was Evie. This one, this plant over here, at one time had root rot, but the plant recovered herself. So when she brought it to me, I tap whatever I think needed to be tapped with glue. So they are hot like a rock, and they're gonna recover it. By the time she pick them up, they're gonna be all good. I don't want nobody to see her name or anything else. It's private, guys. You cannot see my friend's number. So they're okay. They're healthy when she brought them to me. The only thing is I'm gonna stabilize them for her for 6 weeks. And when she take it home, I love this one. Look at this. Is this a beautiful plant that she had? She thought they were in trouble. They were not too much trouble. They were totally healthy. The only thing, we put them in the right soil now, the right fertilizer, stabilize them, let them grow, and then she will take it home. So that's what it is in here, okay? So let's go over here. I make something for Lucas. I'm gonna show you what I make for Lucas.
Yippee-ki-yay.
I make you something, Lucas. You're gonna be so happy, huh? I know you really need it. Watch.
Is it a cheeseburger?
Oh, wow. Watch what I make for you. Okay. Okay. This is how it is. And this is Meow Meow's brother. This is Meow Meow's brother. Look at this. Oh, my God. It's stuck in there. This is Meow Meow. Look at that. Look at that. So, anyway, every time I need you to keep this in here and don't move it, people don't care about see me. They want to see information, no, Maria. Okay? So keep you up, don't move. Please keep it in there for at least maybe 20 seconds. That way people can read it. Okay? And then I'm going to tell you what this says. Okay? Very, very important. This is priority number one in this video. Okay? What it is, every plant that you have, either it's a seedling, it's a year old, you buy it from Walmart, you buy it from Home Depot, or you buy it from me, doesn't matter where you bought it, okay? This is the step you have to take it to re-root it. Every time you pull a plant out of the soil and repairing something else, this is what the plant needs to recover, otherwise it's gonna die. If you don't do this, the plant is gonna die. So this is what you need to do. And this apply to root plants, that you apply glue, to grafted plants, to sealed plants, to transplant plants, and they will not lose the leaves, they will not get stressed, and will be 100% success. Now, I'm walking this morning in my garden and I see this. I go, oh my God. Guess what happened to this baby? This baby, you can see here, that I cut it, okay, I cut it here. I didn't dry it in the soil, in the sun, and I didn't apply the glue, okay? I cut it, dry it in the storage, maybe 3-4 months ago, maybe, I said 3 months ago, and this is what happened. I guarantee you, if I did dry it in the sun, or outside, where the gnats don't got there, and root rot it, and nasty stuff, when I planted was dry, but this is what happened. Since it was open, that observed humidity and killed my plant, okay? There's nothing left in here. You can see it's all gone. This one is really not safe. I wish I can, but it's not. It's totally done, okay? So this is it, okay? That's done with that. Where's my alcohol? Man, my alcohol is very important because I just touched a root rot plant. Oh, you were eating something, don't touch your plants. Every time you touch your plants, don't touch your hands.
So that's what you made me, a plant with
root rot? No, you wait until you see it. You're going to be excited. You're going to send, maybe even give it to your girlfriend for Christmas. You wait what I make for you. Some crazy ideas come to my head. I don't know why. Anyway, so what it is, these plants over here, they are seedlings, and I did have some trouble with them in the beginning. Why? Because when you buy a plant and you take it out of the soil, you cannot leave it sitting for too long. Why? The plant is alive. If you take the plant out of the soil and put it to dehydrate, then you think, well, Maria told me to dehydrate for 2 weeks, and if I dehydrate it, I have a high chance of the plant making it because it's gonna dry. No, 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 things change. If you wanna follow me and go with my crazy ideas and my stuff, and you know I'm trying, and it's at this point, I feel almost very comfortable with my plants, and I know I'm passing the right information, okay? So, when I plant them, I put them in the dark in the storage for a week or so. So that was a no, no, no. Also, when I plant them, what I did, oops, come on. When I plant these plants, I don't want to disturb them. I had like maybe 100 that I saved that were gonna die. And you can see they look good. They are a little dehydrated. But remember, desert roses are very, very slow growers and very, very slow recovery when they get sick. So what I did, I cut them up after I had a problem that I didn't do it right when I planted. As soon as you get them, then and you pull them out of the pot, you plant them and you wanna plant them and you're gonna do this. Exactly this. Okay, that's what you're gonna do after you plant them. For every plant that you repot, doesn't matter what the situation or what the reason, you have to repot it. Okay, this is what you're gonna do. Okay, so after that, that's what I did to this. These already passed the 6 weeks stage. They're already out the danger. And they're already out of the danger. And I can count with my hands how many I lost. Okay. And I don't even put glue, to be honest with you, in these ones. Okay. I don't even have to put the glue. That's why I lost few. Otherwise, I guarantee you I lost 7A will be lower percentage. So this is it. Let's look at what's going on. Okay. I'm gonna disturb them. So now I gotta put it in the shade the 6 weeks again, okay? Let's see what happened. The other day I make a video, but it was very late at night and was dark. You see those little strings there? They are rooting, okay? This one is rooting, okay? This white, I don't wanna touch them, but there's new roots, okay? The plant is dehydrated, that's smart. I don't worry about that 1%. Why? Because I'm gonna repot them and I'm gonna put them to rest again and do the 6 weeks thing. Why? Because I just pull it out of the soil. The roots doesn't mean anything. Let's check this one. I really don't wanna disturb them, but I had to show you. Okay, this is a plant that I cut there. You can see I cut it there. Where is my little thing over here? I don't have it. But you can see that I cut it there, okay? And you can see all these is new roots. So I'm gonna have to plant it and baby it. Okay, this one over here, come on baby, come on. Everybody wants to see you, you're beautiful. Beautiful baby. Okay, there you go. You see that? So what happened, I cut it here. I don't even have to put glue because I was not putting glue in the roots before. I was kinda not sure about it until I tried. And this is what happened. For best result is to use this glue. If you don't use this glue, you have less chance to save it. With this glue, I don't expect anybody to tell me Maria lost my plant. Please don't, because I'm gonna say, what? You lost your plant? Why? Why? Anyway, let's check it out, these two. There you go. You see this? You see? Over here, I sanitized my hands hard like a rock. And I didn't put glue at the time. If I put glue, this would be more successful and more big. This one, here it is. You see that? Again, the same thing. You see that? I cut it there because it was root rot, and look at this. And of course, the root rot, I can say, was 100% my fault. So there you go. There is done. Okay, now, let's show you what I made for Lucas. He's gonna be so excited to take it home. Okay, I buy this, I have this here available for everybody that comes visit. If I'm not here, ask for one or for the full page. And it's very important when I send like 80 desarrosas a week ago, you follow my instructions, okay? Otherwise, it's gonna be a problem with your desarrosa. Okay, I went to, I think, Walmart, and I see these baskets, very beautiful baskets, but they have a liner, okay? And I say, oh, I love this basket for the garden. I can do so many things. I can put bromelias in here. I can put a little cocoa liner in here and do so many things. And that will be so nice. But again, they have these liners. And I'm going with these liners. I have three sizes. Large, medium, and small. And I go, oh my God.
I know where you're going with this.
No, just stop it. Stop it.
I know where you're going with this.
No, you don't. You are saying it's my sign. You are Sagittarius, but you're not going. You don't know what I'm doing because I never showed it to you before. So stop saying you know.
Okay.
This is so much fun. My belly is hurting. I make one for you. And one for your girlfriend. What's her name? Alexa. One for you and for Alexa. Anyway, I said, my God, I don't want to throw this. It's so beautiful, 100% cotton, lightweight. You can almost see through, okay? I love this, so I go, what I can do? What does this look like?
I knew you were going to go there without.
You can make it for your husband. Don't ever throw the liners. You can use your baskets in the garden. They're so beautiful. You can do so many things with these baskets, but don't throw the liners. You can make a little underwear for your granddaughter. You can make them for your husband.
Those look like garden diapers.
Oh, you can, no, what?
They look like garden diapers.
Lucas, stop. Let me tell you something, okay? Do you know that when I was growing up, I swear, when I was growing up, my father's aunt, she was a sister, and she refused that I cannot wear regular underwear. You know, this is how she make them? They only did like this, and I go to school like this. I go to school with this underwear. No elastic in here. There were seams in here like this, okay? Nice and finished in there, all over the leg. But I go to school, the only difference was close over here, and I have a button in here. A button close over here, they have string, just like this, okay? Like that. And I have a little button in here. The things used to have little pleats in here, okay? I don't know why, but she put pleats in there. Anyway, I'm going to school with my dress and my backpack. Go home. You're talking about bullying, huh? 60 years ago, almost no, 50 years ago in the Mexico, okay? You think it's no bullies. Well, guess what? Surprise! Everywhere's bullies all, I guess, all our lives. I'm walking to my home because everybody walks. I'm walking to my house, maybe 10 blocks from the school. This little boy always pick at me, okay? Always like to pick at me. I think he liked me and I didn't like him, so I didn't care for him. He was very, he thinks he was all like, ugh. So I didn't care for him, I always ignored him. So he goes back to my dress and he goes, let me help you with your suitcase, Maria. No, let me help you with your suitcase. And he pulls my dress like that. That's what they did in the school back then. Let me help you with your suitcase. They will pull your dress up and see your underwear. So everybody's wearing nice underwear like me. This is stuff I'm wearing. Everybody started making fun of me. And I'm so pissed off. I was not crying or anything. I had my backpack. I remember getting my backpack like this and walking my way in the floor. He ended in the floor. He never messed with me again. He was, I think he was a couple, 2-3 years older than me. And so he always behind me and walking and want to pull my dress, help in my suitcase. I don't know what that means, happy with suitcase. But I got him good. So don't let anybody bully you. It's strong. They'll tell you ugly. You tell him you're uglier than me. Nobody ever bullied me ever because I never let anybody. You don't let people bully you ever, ever. So this is for you, Lucas, and I have one for Alexa. I'm not joking. Alexis. Ooh, what a beautiful name, your girlfriend. Anyway, I'm very sure she will enjoy them, and I'm gonna give it to you. Two I have, one for you. So don't ever throw you basket liners, okay? You can put a little. You can go on the machine and sew in here. Sewing. I'm serious. I'm not joking now. You can sew them over here like this. In the machine, beautiful, nice finish in there. Don't put elastic, and you can go in the pool with them. You can either go sleep with them.
I don't even know why I'm still videotaping you.
Because you like this underwear. And look at how nice they are. They're cotton, they're so nice, they're 100% cotton. Can you imagine you feel like you don't have bridges and everything? So I'm gonna fold them very nice for you and finish here, okay? So this is it for this video. Until next time from Maria's Garden. And don't throw this stuff away. Recycle, recycle. I'm very sure you can use it or your husband can use it.